Hi everyone, welcome to LeetCode programming. In this video, let's try to solve the daily challenge together. So the problem is, check if two string arrays are equivalent. Given two string arrays word1 and word2, return true if the two arrays represent the same string and false otherwise. A string is represented by an array if the array elements concatenated in order forms the string. So let's look at examples to see what we are going to solve. So we have two arrays, word1 and word2. So both the words are arrays of strings. So we have AB as one string and C as one string in word1 array. In word2 array, we have A as one string and BC as one string. So we need to check if the strings concatenated in the given array in both the arrays are equivalent or not. So if we concatenate these strings, word1 represents the string ABC, because concatenating AB and C will give you ABC. Same way, word2 represents the string A plus BC, so which is ABC. So both the strings are same, so we need to return true in this case. So in example 2, we have word1 as A and CB, and word2 as AB and C. So here, when we concatenate the strings, we get ACB as string 1. Then we get ABC as string 2, so they both are not equal. So our output will be false. In example 3, we have three strings in the first array, ABC, D, DE, FG. So in the word2, we have only one string, so that is ABC, D, DE, FG. So if you concatenate the strings in the first array, so we get ABC, D, DE, FG, which is same as the string in word2 array. So output is true. Let's look at the constraints. So the length of word1 and word2 can be from 1 to 10 power 3. So there can be 10 power 3 strings in neither of the arrays, the max. And the length of each string in the word arrays will be again from 1 to 10 power 3. So the each string length, the max can be 10 power 3, and the length of each array can be 10 power 3. And the word length, again, the length of sum of all the characters in the word array. So if we consider the length of all the strings, combined length of all the strings in the given words, in the given word arrays, it will be between 1 to 10 power 3. And word 1 of i and word 2 of i consist of lowercase letters. So we don't have to worry about capital alphabets. So these strings will be formed using only lowercase letters. Okay, so let's look at there are two hints provided. So let's look at the hints. So we need to concatenate all the strings in the first array into a single string. So we get a string 1 using a concatenation of all strings in the first array, and we do the same thing for second array. That means we concatenate all the given strings in the second array and form string 2. Then finally check if the strings are equal or not. So we need to compare every character in both the strings and check if they are same or not. If they are same, that means the strings are equivalent. Then we return true. Okay, so by seeing this hints here, it is anyway a simple method. So we just have to implement the code for the hints provided here. So let's try to solve the problem together. Let's first try a C++ solution. So let's define two string variables, s1 and s2. So as provided in the hints, let's try to form final string using all the strings provided in the first vector, so word1. So string str in word1. So we concatenate the string to our first string. And we do the same thing for the second array. String str in word2, s2 plus equal to str. So this is a short form for for loop. We can even use for standard way of I equal 0, I less than, string length, word1 dot length, and I++. That way also we can use, but this is a regularly used short form. Then finally, we have s1 and s2 strings with all the strings from the array1 and array2. So we need to check if every character in the string 1, s1 and s2 are same or not. So again, we can check with a for loop. If they both the strings are equal or not, we directly have a method like s1 equal to s2, because string class supports equal to method. Just like how we compare integers, we can compare strings also. So equal to operator is overloaded by the string class. So this will give us whether both the strings are equal or not. So let's run and check. Yeah, so expected answer is true and our answer is true. So it works fine. So let's code a Java solution now. It will be same. So let's take two strings. In Java, we need to initialize the variables, otherwise it will give a compilation error. So s2 equal to 2. And in Java, we use string class. Our string class is, it starts with capital S, whereas in C++, it is small s. Now we can use the same for loop format even in Java. Then add a string to s1. Same way we form the string, final string for array 2, which is port 2. Then we add substring to our s2 string. So now we have both the strings in s1 and s2. So s1 represents the final string, concatenation of all the strings in word 1, and s2 represents the final string of concatenation of all the strings from word 2. So in Java, Java string method doesn't have this overloaded operator. So we use equals method. So equals is a method which checks if two objects are equal or not. So we can use equals method. So that will return true if both are equal. Let's run and check it. Yeah, it works fine. So let's submit. So the solution hasn't been accepted. Let's submit C++ as well. Then we can check the time complexity and space complexity. Yeah, so this also has been accepted. Let's check the runtime. So runtime of 1 milliseconds for Java. And a runtime of 0 milliseconds for C++. So let's look at the time complexity. So we are iterating every string from the word and every string from word 2. So, and space complexity is 0 because we are not using any additional space. So space complexity is 0. And time complexity is, let's say we have n words. Let's say we have n strings in word 1 and word 2, and length of each string is m, each substring from word 1 and word 2. So in that case, our time complexity will be n star m. So a maximum of n strings we are going to iterate here. And then each string will have a length of m, so it will be in the order of O of n star m. So that will be our time complexity. Thanks for watching.